Hey folks, welcome to Jaguar Studios. This is Jay and you are watching All About Drones. Today we're gonna unbox this bad boy.
The DJI Mavic Air.
Isn't going to be a typical unboxing since I've been using it for a while now. Quick disclaimer, this is just going to be an overall review of the product. I'll be making a detailed video in a while.
It comes in Arctic White, Flame Red and Onyx Black.
It's time to see what's in store.
Prop guards, intelligent flight batteries, the drone, the controller, charging unit and some cables.
Now this thing is so teeny, I just want to show you its size. Now this is my phone, this is my drone, look at its size, literally it's the size of my phone, it's so impressive, it is packed with so much features despite its size.
I am amused by the way it sneaks into my pocket thanks to its foldable design.
So a couple of prop guards, these things are for beginners, let's try setting it up. Now this controller is just like the Mavic Pro without a screen. Wait a minute, something else is missing. That's the controller sticks. The controller sticks are hidden inside the controller. Now DJI provides two cables out of the box. This one is the small cable is a USB-B type and the longer one is a USB-C type. Anyhow, you get a converter from C type. You can use it depending on which type your phone supports. Before you insert your battery to the drone, make sure you take the cover off the gimbal. This thing is used to protect the gimbal, but in case you insert the battery keeping this cover on, it's going to harm your camera.
You shouldn't be seeing this red mark at all once you have inserted the battery. This is where you insert your SD card.
First, I'll switch on my controller. Then I'll switch on my drone. You should be having a DJI Go 4 app installed in your mobile device before you could fly this thing.
Talking about the technical specs, the $800 drone comes with a three-directional environment sensing. It has a range of about 4 kilometers and flight time is claimed to be 21 minutes. But in practical conditions, it's just about 16 minutes, give or take 30 seconds. DJI has introduced enhanced Wi-Fi system in place of the OcuSync technology. I know not a lot of people would welcome this, but it's not that bad in my experience. The top speed of the drone is 68.4 kph. About the camera and video quality, the sensor size in this drone is same as the one in the Spark or a Mavic Pro. You can take 12 megapixel photos and record videos in 4K at 30 fps. There is a 3-axis gimbal stabilization, which means you get a lot better videos than the Spark. The bandwidth has been increased from 60 to 100 mbps, which simply means 100 megabit is the amount of data that is written on the SD card for every second, which is by the way unmatched in the segment. Also, there is 8 gigs of internal storage, just in case you forgot your SD card. I know you won't, but it's still there for you. Also, we have plenty of other features like obstacle avoidance, APAS, gesture control, smart capture, one press takeoff landing, dedicated button for return to home, and return to home on low battery and signal loss. To conclude everything, this drone is awesome. That's it. Like, share, subscribe, and let me know what you think of this drone in the comment section. Also get free access to the Aero library in the description.